In a previous video, we talked about interphase, which is the bulk of a cell's life cycle as it grows and its DNA replicates and it grows some more. And now we're going to talk about the actual cell division. We're going to talk about mitosis. And if we wanted to be precise, mitosis is the process by which this one nucleus will turn into two nuclei that each have the original genetic information. Now, as we exit mitosis, we get into cytokinesis, which will then split these two nuclei into, or they'll put each of the nuclei into a separate cell when we split the cytoplasm right over here, when we split the or the cell essentially turns into two cells. But let's see how all of this happens. So the first phase, and I'll leave the end of interphase right over here. We have this big cell, our DNA has been replicated. We have two centrosomes right over here. The first phase of mitosis involves the cell, and I might draw it a little bit smaller just so I have enough space here. So this is the cell right over here. So we're gonna go to this phase right over here. And a few things start happening. One, the DNA, the chromosomes, go from being in their chromatin form, where they're all spread out, to kind of a more condensed form that you can actually see from a light microscope. So for example, that magenta chromosome, which is now made up of two sister chromatids after replication, we talk about that in the interphase video, it might look something like this if you were to look in a microscope. It's unlikely to be magenta, but it's gonna have kind of that classic chromosome shape that you're used to seeing in textbooks. And it has the centromere that connects these two sister chromatids. Right now, both of these two sister chromatids combined are considered to be one chromosome. Even though before replication, it was still considered, the magenta stuff was still considered to be one chromosome. And we can draw the blue chromosome. Once again, it's now in the condensed form. That's one sister chromatid right over there. That's another sister chromatid. They are connected at the centromere. So they're condensing now as we enter into mitosis. And the nuclear membrane starts to go away. So the nuclear membrane is starting to go away. And these two centrosomes start to migrate to opposite sides of the cell. So one of them's going over here, and one of them's maybe going to go over here. So they're migrating to opposite sides of the cell. And it's pretty incredible. You know, it's easy to say, oh, this happens and then that happens. But remember, this cell doesn't have a brain. This is all happening through chemical and thermodynamic reactions and the way, you know, just based on certain triggers of where the cell is in its life cycle. It's amazing that this is happening. It's amazing that the structures and what sometimes we consider to be a simple thing, but this actually incredibly complex thing, is actually, it kind of, quote unquote, knows what to do, even though it has no intelligence here. And a lot of what I'm talking about, the general overview of the process is well understood, but scientists are still understanding exactly how do the different things happen when they should happen, and by what mechanism, and what's actually happening sometimes at a molecular or atomic basis. But anyway, this first phase of mitosis, the nuclear envelope, the nuclear membrane starts to disappear. The centrosomes migrate to the opposite ends of the cell, and our DNA condenses into kind of the condensed form of the chromosomes. We call this prophase of mitosis. Now in the next phase, let me draw my cell again. Drew it in that same green color. In the next phase, your nuclear membrane is now gone, and the chromosomes start lining up in the middle of the cells. So you have the blue one right over here. The blue one, that's one sister chromatid. Here's another sister chromatid. And they are connected at the centromere. Not to be confused with a centrosome. And then here's the magenta, one of the magenta sister chromatids, and another one. And once again, it's not magenta in real life, I'm just making it in magenta because it looks nice. That's the centromere right over there. Our centrosomes are at opposite ends of the cell at this point. at opposite ends of the cell. And you might have heard the word, let me label this again. I labeled it in a previous video. That's centrosomes. Centrosomes, where the two sister chromatids are connected. That's a centromere. Centromere. Now you might have heard the word centriole. Centrioles are actually, they exist inside the centrosomes. They're these two kind of cylindrical looking structures. Each of the centrosomes have two centrioles. But for the sake of this video, you could say, well, the centrioles are just part of the centrosomes. But I'm just listing you all the words that involved century something. Centrioles right over there, and you have two of them per centrosome. So hopefully that helps clarify some confusion. But these things line up, and a lot of what you're about to see, this orchestration, these things moving around in the cell, things lining up, and soon things pulling apart, these are all coordinated with actually a fairly sophisticated mechanism of kind of a scaffold of these kind of ropes, these microtubules. And the centrosome's role, until now I've just been kind of drawing them, you're like, well, what do? Well, the centrosome's role is these microtubules extend from them to each other and to the centromeres, of these chromosomes. And to a large degree, although they're not the only actors here, they help pull and push things in the right way. So these help make sure that the two centrosomes push away from each other, and then as we'll see in the next phase, that they're able to pull one of each of the sister chromatids from each of the pairs towards each of them. So this right over here, where you see where the nuclear envelope is now gone, the chromosomes have been lined up just like this, and your centrosomes are on opposite sides of your cell. We call this the metaphase. We call this the metaphase of mitosis. And then you can imagine what's going to happen next. What's going to happen next is, and I don't want to draw it too big because I want to be able to fit it all in one page. What's going to happen next is that those microtubules are going to start pulling on each of the sister chromatids. Let me draw that. So you have this centrosome right over here. You have all these microtubules in your cell. You have this centrosome right over here, all those microtubules. And this one is going to be getting one of the blue chromatids to pull towards it, or to move towards it. So let me draw that. So this is one blue chromatid right over here. And this one is going to be pulling the other blue chromatid towards it. And same thing for the magenta. So that one's being pulled that way, and this one is being pulled that way. And just in case you're concerned about the words, the vocabulary involved, the point at which these microtubules connect to what used to be sister chromatids, but now that they're apart, we now call them chromosomes. This is, when they were merged, this was one chromosome, and they have two sister chromatids, but now they're apart, we would actually now consider these each an independent chromosome. So now you actually have four chromosomes over here. This point right over here, we call a kinetochore, and even exactly how that interface works and exactly how things move is not fully understood. Some of this stuff is understood, but some of this is still an area of research. So something even as basic as cell division, not so basic after all. So this right over here, where you can start to see the DNA kind of migrating to their respective sides of the cell, we call this the anaphase. And then that takes us to the last formal phase of mitosis, and that is called telophase. Telophase. And in telophase, let me do my best job to draw it. And you could already see I've started to draw that the cells, the cellular membrane starting to pinch in, kind of in preparation for cytokinesis, in preparation for the cell splitting into two cells. So I'll do it a little bit more. Cytokinesis is usually described as kind of being a separate process than mitosis, although it is obviously they kind of together help the cell fully turn into two cells. So now in telophase, so you have this, what used to be a sister chromatid, now we could call it a chromosome on its own, and we have this chromosome, and we have this chromosome right over there. Let me actually do it on both sides. So you have there, and you have this right over here. And actually, let me draw it a little bit different. Because at this phase, you're really starting to unwind what happened at prophase. So prophase, you have the disappearance of the nuclear membrane, and you have the condensation of the chromosomes into this form here. Telophase, that's unwinding a little bit. So actually, let me draw the two centrosomes. So you have one centrosome, do that same color that I had before. So you have one centrosome right here. You have another centrosome right over there. And now the DNA, this blue DNA, this chromosome is now here, but it's starting to get unwind a little bit. Same thing on this side right over here. Magenta chromosome is on here, but once again, starting to get a little bit unwound. Same thing over here. And you start to have nuclear membranes forming around the DNA. So once again, it's kind of redoing what was undone in prophase. Undone in prophase. And so when you're done, you're gonna have these nuclear membranes. The DNA is gonna go back to its chromatin form. And then you have cytokinesis. And cytokinesis is the process by which this gets fully pinched together, and you have two separate cells. And some folks will say, oh, it kind of begins in anaphase, and it finishes after telophase, but it's kind of happening near the end of mitosis, in parallel with it. So this is cytokinesis right over here. This essentially is how this larger cell that had two nuclei, how this fully divides into two cells. And at that point, you're back to this phase of the cell cycle. Now each of these now two cells are going to go through interphase. G1, S phase, replicate their DNA, G2 phase, grow some more, and then go through mitosis again. And then these two will turn into four cells. Anyway, hopefully you enjoyed that.